Hello children, today I am going to explain you your next chapter, chapter 12, A Christmas Carol by Charles Dickens. Before start this chapter, let's know about the writer. Charles Dickens was an English writer who is thought to be a great writer for his humor and for how well he could describe what people said and thought. This is a story of an unfriendly miser is believed to have awakened people's minds to the true spirit of Christmas across the world. Now let's start this chapter. Firstly, let's see how many characters are there in this play or story. Narrator 1. Narrator 2. Students, I have already told you that narrator means the person who tells the story. Jacob Marley, Ebenezer Scrooge, Ghost of Christmas Past, Ghost of Christmas Present, Ghost of Christmas Yet to Come, and Passerby. Scene 1. Narrator 1. Ebenezer Scrooge is an unfriendly miser who runs a counting house. He is a man to whom money is dearer than people. The main character of this story is a student of this play is Ebenezer Scrooge. Scrooge is the main character of this story, and he is an unfriendly miser. Miser means a person who loves money and hates spending it. Means then Scrooge is a unfriendly miser and who runs a counting house. Counting house means, you can see, office used by those who keep the accounts of a business. And he is a man to whom money is dearer than people. Dearer means school or his student, more important or valuable. For him, money is more important than the man or person. Or we can say, the person who loves his money more than he cares for people. Narrator 2. It is Christmas Eve and everyone is happy except Scrooge. He keeps himself aloof and does not share the joy of Christmas with anyone. This is the time of Christmas Eve, means the day before the Christmas, means 24th December. As you know, Christmas, we celebrate Christmas on 25th December, and the Christmas Eve means the day before the Christmas. It means this is the day of, and this is 24th December, and everyone was very happy. Only Scrooge is not happy. Why? Because he keep himself aloof. Keep himself aloof means a student stay by himself away from people and does not share the joy of Christmas with anyone. He didn't celebrate Christmas with other people. He does not like the people. He loves, we can say, more money than the people. And students, as we know, Christmas is a season of joy that comes with sharing and caring. And we can say the narrator brings out the sharp contrast between the season of goodwill and the miser who keeps to himself on the night before Christmas. Narrator 1. Then a strange thing happened that night. The spirit of his dead friend Jacob Marley visits him. Then what happened? Strange things had happened that night, means on 24th December. The spirit of his dead friend Jacob Marley visit to Scrooge. Then let's see what happened. Marley tries to make Scrooge understand that there are more important things in life than making money. When Marley come visit to Scrooge, he tried to understand Scrooge that there are more important things in life than making money. And the spirit of his dead friend Jacob Marley visit Scrooge and to ask him to care more for people than for money while he is still, we can say, still alive. He asks Scrooge to change his way while there is still time. Jacob Marley, you still have time, Ebenezer. Jacob Marley warned that Scrooge change his way. Means he warns that the spirit of his friend, dead friend Jacob Marley, warned that he asks to him to care more for people than money, and he while he is still alive, so that he may not be punished for his stinginess after his death. His appearance may be a kind of warning for what is to come. Ebenezer, time for what? Then Ebenezer asks to him, time for what? Marley, time to change and to be kind to those who are poor and needy, especially at this time of year. Then Marley told to him that, change to yourself and to be kind to the poor, the person who are poor and the needy. Help them, especially at this time of the year. At this time, this is the Christmas Eve, and you should change yourself and you should help the poor and the needy person. Now you have time and you should change yourself. Narrator 1, he also tells Scrooge that he will be visited by three spirits. The first would arrive exactly at 1 o'clock, then he leaves. Scrooge is left astonished. Astonished means student, surprise. Now his friend, Scrooge friend, means the spirit of Scrooge friend Marley, told him that he will be visited by three spirits, and the first spirit will come exactly at 1 o'clock. And after that, after telling all these things to Scrooge, he left from there. And after hearing all this thing, Scrooge very surprised. Means students, we can say that the spirit of his friend, of his dead friend, warned that Scrooge become a changed person. He warned that he will not be punished after his death for his stinginess and when he dead. And he warned that he changed himself. And we can, by reading this, we can understand that that Scrooge is a very miser person. He don't have any friends. Only Jacob Marley is his friend. Scrooge, I must be getting old, imagining things like that. It was all a dream, a bad dream. Why would Marley want to visit me? He yawns. After hearing all these things, he thought that it was only a dream. He does not take it seriously, we can say. He thinks he could have imagined it due to his old age. He thought thus just it was a dream. Marley didn't visit him. I had better to go back to bed. That silly dream has upset my sleep. And he again went to sleep. Just then, the clock strikes 1 o'clock. All of a sudden, a ghost appears. It looks like a child, though it has white hair like that of an old man. Scrooge is frightened and speaks in a shaky voice. Are you the visitor I was told would come? When he went to sleep, then when the clock strikes at 1 o'clock, and all of a sudden a ghost appears, means what his friend Marley told, the spirit of his friend Marley told that a ghost visit to him, it's true. And at 1 o'clock a ghost appeared there, and it looked like by face a child, but by his hair it looked like an old man. Why? Because his hair was white in color. And Scrooge is frightened and speaks in shaky voice. Shaky means the student shaking and weak because of fear. And when Scrooge saw him, he became very frightened, and we can say he became very afraid. Are you the visitor I was told would come? He asked to him, Are you the that ghost? Are you the visitor? My friend has told me that you would come. Ghost of Christmas past. Yes, I am. I am the ghost of Christmas past. Then ghost replied that yes, I am the ghost and I am the ghost of Christmas past. As you know, student, there's a three ghosts visit to Scrooge. Then first one is the ghost of Christmas past. Scrooge, why are you here? He asked to the ghost, why you come here? Ghost of Christmas past, I am here for your good. Scrooge looked confused. Come, it's time for us to leave. For your good, means student, in order to help you. Then ghost of Christmas past replied that I came here to help you. After hearing that, Scrooge looks confused. He confused means he thought that how a ghost helped me. And then ghost again said, now it's time to leave us. Let's go from here. Narrator 1. Scrooge is afraid, but the ghost leads him away. Scrooge become very afraid, but ghost took him away. Let's see where he took him. Scene 2. Narrator 2. The ghost then makes Scrooge see what happened in the past. He is made to see the good days of the past and to remember the kindness that others have shown to him. After that, ghost of past took Scrooge in his past time and showed him that what happened in the past time. He is made to see what good days of the past. He showed him the good days of the past and to remember the kindness that the others people have shown to Scrooge. He showed him that how people help him in his past time. Narrator 1. Scrooge slowly begins to understand how unkind he has been to the others, though they have been good to him. He realizes his mistake and begins to weep. After seeing all these things, Scrooge realizes that the people in his past time helped him. They were very good to him. They were very kind to him. But Scrooge didn't help him, and even he was very unkind to him. And after seeing all these things, he realizes his mistake. He realizes his mistake and begin to weep. Means student, the ghost of the past takes Scrooge back to his own childhood to remind him of people who had been kind to him. As Scrooge sees his past, he feels sad and weeps that he is not kind to others as people had been to him. Scrooge, weeping to the ghost, stop, this is so painful. After seeing all this thing, Scrooge starts to weep and he told to ghost of past, ghost of Christmas past, told him, please stop, I don't want to see all these things, please stop, it's very painful, it hurts me. Ghost of Christmas past, these are the things of the past as they happened. I cannot change the past. My time is up. I must go now. My time is up, means student, it's time to leave me. These are the things of the past which I have showed you and I can't change it. The things that happened in the past time, the things that has already happened, no one can change it. Even I can't change it and you also. Now it's time to leave. It's now my time is over. I have to leave. And I must go now. Narrator 2. Soon the ghost leaves and Scrooge is back in his house. He prepares to go back to bed again. When the ghost left, the Scrooge is back in his house and he again went to sleep in his bed. Suddenly he notices a ghost dressed in a long green robe with a wreath on its head. Wreath means the students, a circle of flowers or leaves worn on the head. And robe means a long loose outer garment reaching to the ankles. Then suddenly he noticed a ghost again. And the ghost dressed in a long green robe. The ghost has The ghost has worn a long green robe and with a wreath on its head. Means the second ghost has appeared. Students, till page number 122 I have explained. The next page I will explain in next video. I hope till here you all have understood. Thank you.